Hello everyone, I am User, a basic software engineer, and welcome to episode 2 of my series User Quick Tip video about AUTOSAR architecture. Today, we will be discussing the basic software layer within the AUTOSAR architecture. We will explore the role of the basic software layer, its various sublayers, and understand the purpose of each one. I hope you found this video instructive and informative. Let's get started. To understand the basic software layer in a simple way, try to imagine it as the foundation of a house. Just like a strong foundation supports everything above it, the basic software layer supports the entire software stack in a vehicle. Let's start with the first role of this layer, which is to provide standardized services. Think of the basic software layer as the utilities in our houses, like water, electricity, and internet, which are standardized services that we need to live comfortably. In the same way, the basic software is acting, providing essential services for developing automotive software, such as communication and memory management, ensuring that all parts of the software work together seamlessly and reliably. Another role of the basic software is to provide middleware functionality. You know that universal remote control that can control any TV regardless of the brand? Basic software layer is doing the same. This layer acts as an intermediary between the hardware, which is the microcontroller, and the application software, making sure they communicate effectively without worrying about the specific details of the hardware. Additional essential role of the basic software layer is to support real-time operations. Basic software layer is literally like a traffic control system in a busy city. It ensures that time-critical tasks are executed predictably and on time. This is crucial for real-time operation in a vehicle, like deploying airbag during an accident or managing engine control system. So, the basic software layer is like the backbone of the vehicle's software, providing standardized services, acting as a middleware, and supporting real-time operations to ensure everything runs smoothly and effectively. Now, let's take a closer look at the basic software layer in AUTOSAR and its division into four distinct sublayers: the MCAL layer, the ECU abstraction layer, the services layer, and the complex drivers layer. Think of it like building with Lego blocks. Each block has a specific role, making it easy to swap or upgrade parts without redoing everything. This makes our system more flexible, easier to maintain, and reusable. The basic software is divided into these sublayers to modularize and standardize the software components. This modularity allows for better abstraction, easier maintenance, and greater flexibility. Each layer focuses on a specific aspect of the hardware interactions and system services. By doing so, AUTOSAR promotes reusability and scalability, making it easier to develop and integrate complex automotive software systems. Microcontroller Abstraction Layer. The Microcontroller Abstraction Layer, or MCAL, is the lowest layer of the basic software. It connects directly with the car's hardware, which is the microcontroller. The purpose of this layer is to make higher software layers work smoothly without dealing with the hardware details. We can simulate it to the operating system on our phone that lets application run without knowing the phone's hardware details. The MCAL layer includes drivers like ADC for reading sensor data, PWM for controlling motors, CAN for car communication, and SPI for talking to peripherals or sensors. It's the part of the basic software who make the system reliable and easy to manage. ECU Abstraction Layer. The ECU Abstraction Layer acts as a bridge between the software and hardware. This layer offers API for access to peripherals and devices regardless of their location and their connection to the microcontroller. It includes drivers like EEPROM, which stores important data even when the car is off, and watchdogs, which monitor the system to keep it running properly. It also provides diagnostic and input-output management, which handle input and output signal, ensuring everything communicates effectively. Services layer. The services layer is the top part of the basic software. It provides essential services like operating system, network communication, memory management, and diagnostic. To understand it easily, Think of it as the manager of smart home system. As the name reveals, it's the manager, means the one who ensures everything runs correctly. It really handles everything, from doing the diagnostic to managing memory until communication between different systems. To not confuse the role of the services layer and the ECU abstraction layer, let's say that the ECU abstraction layer is that specialized technician ensuring all hardware components are in synchronization. However, the services layer is the manager of the entire system. Don't confuse between the hardware component management and the system management. Complex drivers layer. Last layer of the basic software is the complex drivers layer or CDD layer. This layer handles special tasks that are not covered by the standard AUTOSAR layers. It integrates special-purpose drivers for devices with high timing need or unique function. This layer is what makes things customized, as it ensures complex and perform critical application. Always remember, if your car has a unique sensor or a high-performance device, the CDD is the hero behind managing it. Is the one who is ensuring that everything works perfectly together. Before ending, I want to highlight that the four suppliers of the basic software are further divided into various parts, each containing several modules. These modules are organized into stack, which group related functionalities together. We have the system services part. It includes modules that provide essential operating system functions. Then we have the memory services part. It consists of modules related to memory management, forming the memory stack. After, we have the crypto services part. This one includes modules for security function, forming the crypto stack. Then we have communication services part. This one is divided into modules handling different type of communication. Offboard communication plus communication services. All those create the communication stack. And we have also the input-output stack that contain modules that abstract the input-output hardware details like sensor data acquisition or actuator control. Each of these stacks ensure that all related functionalities are handled in a coherent and organized manner, making the overall system more efficient and easier to maintain. As we conclude, let's quickly summarize the key takeaways. The first point, that is the basic software layer, offers a standardized and modular approach. It ensures that the software development in automotive ECUs is standardized and modular. Think of it like using Lego blocks to build various structures. Each block, or module in the AUTOSAR case, fits together in a standardized way, making it easy to assemble, replace, or upgrade parts without redesigning the entire system. This modularity simplifies development and ensures consistency across different projects. Also, the basic software layer enhances portability, scalability, and maintainability, as it makes the software easy to move, grow, and maintain. To be able to remember these features of the basic software layer, imagine having a universal charger that works with different types of the devices. Portability means you can use the same software on different hardware platforms. It's the same. You can use the same charger for all the devices you have at your home. Scalability allows you to add more features or handle larger workloads without major change. And maintainability ensures that fixing bugs or updating software is straightforward, much like easily changing a part in a standardized machine. Another plus offered by the basic software layer is independency from specific hardware details. The basic software layer allows higher software layers to function without worrying about the specific hardware. For this point, we can give as a real example to understand better is to think of it like using an app on your phone without needing to know how the phone's internal hardware works. Whatever is your phone, you can download and use it. This abstractions means developer can focus on software functionality without getting bogged down by hardware-specific issues, making the development process more efficient. Last features is that our fantastic basic software layer supports integration and application software with hardware. The basic software layer bridges the gap between application software and hardware, ensuring they work well together, simply. Achieving the end of our video, I would like to thank you for joining me, and I hope this video has explained you well what is the basic software layer and what it do, and the example given was helpful enough to provide you a plus on your AUTOSAR knowledge. Please tell me if this video was clear and informative enough or not. Also, how did you find the clarity of my voice and the pace of my speaking? Please don't hesitate to comment. Your feedback is invaluable to me. Thank you again and stay tuned for more insights in future episodes of Yusra's Quick Tips video.